He's the artist who rose to fame against all odds.
I remembered my child life, that we used to dance, we used to sing along, we used to do whatever, we used to play soccer, we used to, like, very dirty, no clothes on, nothing. We looked very poor, but we were happy.
Eddy Kenzo, the Ugandan artist who found inspiration for his award-winning music in his motherland.
When you come to our streets, you're gonna see people on the streets playing drums, singing. Namasuba natete namugongo, namasuba natete namugongo, Kampala, Masaka, Mbarara, whatever. It is nice. It's such a good feeling. So I'm like, Africa's actually also good and so much blessed.
You were homeless for some time after you lost your mum when you were a child. And so how did that impact your desire to give back to the youth of today?
I decided to use my story. That my story, childhood, street life, struggling, hustling, has taught me a lot, and it's the reason why I'm doing all this. So it has impacted me to make sure that I change the community. When I saw the ghetto kids, I called their manager. I'm like, guys, I have a good concept. I'm so thankful to God that it worked. Today, these kids, they're in French Montana video, Unforgettable, and it's about to reach 1 billion views. And it's one of French Montana's biggest song ever. So when we did City of Loss, so many ghetto children, they were inspired. We received a lot of videos from Kenya, from Tanzania, from Gabon, from Benin, from everywhere, from Nigeria. All kids are doing this.
So it's one of the ways that you choose to help them, featuring them in your music
in
videos.
In my music videos, like I'm like, this is the song. Do whatever you do. If it's great, maybe you can get a chance and be recognized.
So tell me about the school that you founded or that you fund in Masaka.
Their kids have a very terrible school. It is like a house. They have no shoes. They have no uniform. But I'm trying to get what I can to fund this school, and I'm doing that every time. I buy uniforms, I buy them shoes, I buy them books, pens. I'm still on that level.
You beat some African artists to win the Favorite African Star Award at the Nickelodeon Kids' Choice Awards in 2018. How did that make you feel?
It is unbelievable. It is such a great feeling, I can't even explain. Me, I grew up not watching TV. You can't believe I didn't know about Nickelodeon until my nomination.
Wow.
Yeah.
So because it's such an international platform,
How
did it make you feel that, one, you were nominated, then you even won?
I saw the shows and how people cry, these people, big people cry to get one. And I'm like, should I faint right now or no? You know what I mean?
What would be one of the most important pieces of advice that you would give young people who look up to you?
Don't copy and paste. Just get inspired and change something. Come with some uniqueness about that.